Hey guys, this is Robin from the Back Pain Secret Podcast, and today I'm going to talk about 11 things that you can cause you back pain, okay? There are many things that can cause you back pain, but these are 11 very common things that a lot of people struggle with, okay?
So, here's the important question. How can back pain sufferers like us, who don't want to use prescription drugs or go through surgery, heal our back pain? How do we live our daily lives in a way that allows us to go to work, take care of our families, enjoy life, and still manage our back pain? That is the question, and this podcast will give you the answer. My name is Robin Wakeham, and welcome to Back Pain Secrets.
So first off, weak back muscles. I hear this from a lot of patients that come in, you know. They say, well, my back muscles are so weak. Or they say, I don't even have any back muscles, you know, that's why I'm in pain. Guys, everyone has back muscles. Everyone has muscles in their bodies. Of course, we can work them more, or we can be stronger or not as strong, okay? But I see a tendency, especially the over the past few years now, I have a lot of patients that do these, using these apps on the phones, right? They're doing like 100 push-ups every night, or they're doing 100 sit-ups, okay? And a lot of these exercises are focusing on training the front of the body, okay? And because we're sitting all day, most of us like this in front of the computer, we have a tendency just when we're training, doing the push-ups and a lot of sit-ups, you know, we increase that posture. So most common, the most common problem is that you're actually irritating or making your posture even worse when you're doing all of this. You might get the six pack, but you have this posture and that's killing your back pain, okay? Number two, muscles or ligaments. Well, of course, guys, you can injure your muscles or your ligaments, especially when you're doing heavy stuff in the gym. I have a lot of patients that do a lot of heavy squats, okay, deadlifts, and all of this stuff, okay? I'm not saying that you shouldn't do it. I'm just saying that make sure that you do it in a correct manner and don't overdo it, okay? You need to keep the weight as high or as low so you can perform the exercise in the way it's supposed to be performed, okay? Very, very important. Number three, bad posture. We already touched on that, okay? But it's because most people are sitting down. We're sitting down or we are on our phones, okay? Looking down or we're sitting. Looking down, okay? So what you need to do, you need to start standing up at work at least 3 hours a day at work. You need to go for your walk, 40 minutes. And when you hit the gym or do other exercises, please do exercises when you're training your postural muscles, okay? When you're pulling stuff towards yourself, okay? That's about it. Also, number four, stress, okay? Stress. I've talked about stress a lot on this podcast, and it's because it's the low-hanging fruit, guys. If you're stressed, if you're working a lot, if you have like work is crazy, your family life is crazy, your relatives are crazy, your friends are just all over the place, and you don't have any routine, not any structure in your life, well, chances are that you're stressed. Okay, so you need to sit down, you need to write down on a piece of paper what is important for you and what is not important. Then you basically just do the stuff that's important for you, okay? That's about it. What else? Number five, too little or bad sleep. Guys, first off, people are watching Netflix. If you're watching Netflix in your bed, on your phone, on your computer, if you have your phone in bed with you, next to you, okay, well, I can't really help you, okay? You need to get all of the electronical shit out of the bedroom, okay? Very, very important. Also, if you need to go to work, to be at work at 8 or 9, okay? And you need to get your 8 hours of sleep, you can't be in bed watching this shit all night long and fall asleep at 1 o'clock and then wondering why you're not feeling good or your back pain hurts, okay? You need to get like 7 or 8 hours of sleep per night, okay? Exercise every day, stand up at work, go for your walks, don't drink coffee after 12 in the day, okay? And get all the electronical stuff out of your bedroom, okay? Number six, addictions. Right here, I'm having a cup of coffee here, okay? But I'm just having 2 cups, okay? So if you're over consuming food, if sugar, alcohol, tobacco or other drugs, okay? You need just to reduce all the stuff that you're taking, okay? I'm not going to go all into that, you know, but you need to keep your eating habits and the stuff that you're consuming into your body to a reasonable level, okay? Or else you're going to have medical problems. It's as easy as that. Number seven, unresolved feelings. This is a big one, okay? People are walking around. I meet a lot of patients in here that are all like all bundled up. They're walking around, you know, they're checking out what other people are doing, and they're very nervous of what other people think of them, how they should act. They're struggling with these feelings. Am I enough, you know? Will I be able to do that? Blah blah blah. I understand that if you're younger, okay, up to your 20s, but when you reach like in your 30s, 40s, and 50s, okay, and if you're not hurting anyone, if you treat everyone with kindness and respect, and you're not hurting anyone, okay, and you're just doing your thing, okay, if people have a problem with that, okay, you know, you're better off without them, okay. That's very easy way to see look upon this, you know. If you're not hurting anyone, if you treat everyone with kindness and respect, and you're doing your own thing, okay, and you have a positive attitude, if people have a problem with you, well, good luck to them, okay. Just make that decision in your life. It's the best one you can make. Okay, number eight, spondylosis or spondylolysis. What it is, guys, it's, I'm not going to get too technical here, but when you have like a disc or a vertebrae that has slipped forward, it can press on your nerves, okay? And your nerves are these small yellow things on, you can see here, okay? And it presses here, and you can have like radiation down your legs, you can have pain in your lower back, and you're usually very sensitive to what kind of activities you're doing, okay? So that's one medical problem you can have. Then you can have like a herniated disc. And a herniated disc, we're talking a lower body part here now, but you can have that in all kinds of, like up in your neck, in your midsection or your lower back. But I'm talking about the lower back here now. So what we see here is a disc, okay? And a disc is almost like a tree, you know. If you cut a tree off, you will see these rings. And a disc is built up in the same manner. So if the rings break, you will have fluid that runs out. And that fluid will run out and will press on the nerves in your back. And you can feel radiation down your leg, in your buttocks. And it can be just horrible, actually. Lower back pain. Lower back pain is a term that can be dependent on many different factors. Your posture, stress, you can have a medical condition, okay? So it's more like a term that you can use that's not specific. Also sciatica. Most people know what sciatica is. They've experienced sciatica. And it's, again, it's this, the biggest nerve, or one of the biggest nerves in the body is the sciatic nerve. It goes, this is the front, but on the back, it goes on the, runs back of your leg all the way down to your foot. And if you have some problems up here, or even like in your hip area, you can have pressure on your sciatica nerve. And that results in that you have a radiation down your leg or your buttocks. A lot of people that have sciatica, they have this tendency to go and hit their buttocks, okay? They feel like, shit, there's something in my butt, okay? Most common, it's a bit of sciatica you have there. You need to do some stretching for your buttocks and your lower back. Okay, guys, that's about it for today. Listen through this again, okay? This won't solve all of your problems, but these are 11 very common things that you can, like, just be, if you just know about them and you can make some small corrections in your life, you might help you out quite a bit, okay? Take care, guys. I love you. I'll talk to you tomorrow. And don't forget, you're just one step away from healing your back pain. Bye-bye.
Want more back pain seekers? Then go ahead and get your free copy of my best-selling book, Back Pain Secrets, at backpainsecrets.com. Inside this book, you will find my top secrets to healing your back pain without prescription drugs or surgery that have helped thousands of other people just like you.